Hi guys, it's Olufukeji here, and you're welcome to the third video in the series Fishing for Gold, Fishing for God. In my previous video, we established that growing in wisdom and stature or capacity brings you favor with God and man, Luke chapter 2 verse 52. And Jesus grew in wisdom and stature or capacity and enjoyed favor with God and man. Increased productivity, increased influence, increased access, and increased income in 2016 will come as a result of favor. What do I mean by favor? Favor is simply being singled out from amongst your colleagues, your contemporaries, your peers for special, preferential, exceptional treatment. Favor is being singled out from amongst your peers for special, exceptional treatment. For example, if I'm thirsty and I walk into a store, there's Coke, there's Pepsi, there's Macacera, there's malt, and I choose to buy Coke, what I have done is I have favored Coca-Cola. If I work in an organization and they are downsizing, sacking staff, and I am exempted from that, what I have enjoyed is favor. If I'm an entrepreneur, I offer a service or sell a product, and people stop patronizing other brands, but they don't stop patronizing mine, what I am enjoying at that point is favor. You see why I say the results that we need in 2016, that favored career, the favored finances are crucial. What then do we do to get or access this favor? Well, favor is a function of your offering. By offering, I don't mean money. I mean what you are bringing to the table. What uniqueness are you serving God and humanity with? It's very important. It's very crucial. Let's look at the story of the first person who ever enjoyed favor in the Bible, Genesis chapter 1, the story of Cain and Abel. The Bible says that Abel was a keeper of flock, a tender of flock, while Cain was a tiller of the ground. And both of them had a harvest, they had increase, and they brought to God an offering from their increase. Abel brought the fat of his firstlings, while Cain brought the first fruits of the ground. The Bible says God accepted Abel and his offering and rejected Cain and his offering. And Cain was upset. And God asked Cain, he said, why are you upset that I didn't favor you? If you had done the right thing, wouldn't you have enjoyed favor? So favor is a consequence of doing the right thing. What then is the right thing? Well, to really understand why God accepted Abel and rejected Cain, we need to look a step backwards. Genesis chapter 1 and 2, the story of the Garden of Eden. The Bible says God furnished the Garden of Eden with all the resources that they required. And then God now placed man, Adam and Eve, in the garden and instructed them to dress and tend the garden. That was their work. You need to understand that with God, work is not what you do for survival. Work is not what you do to make ends meet. Work is not what you do to put food on your table to pay bills. No. To God, in God's divine order, work is what you do to unlock, refine, and reveal your inner abundance, your God-given deposit. Work is what you do to unlock, refine, and reveal your God-given deposit. It is a lower order to work to make ends meet. From the beginning, it wasn't so. So, we had a scenario where Abel was a steward, a tender, a keeper, unlocking and refining and revealing his inner potential. However, Cain was a toiler, a tiller of the ground that God had cursed. And so Cain was laboring to make ends meet. In 2016, your attitude has to change. Tell yourself, I will develop the attitude of a steward, a keeper, unlocking, refining, and revealing my inner potential. Why? The Bible says, from the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. There is abundance on your inside. More abundance on your inside than you can ever find on your outside. I end with this story. Two individuals working in a bank as accountants. One is working like a steward, like a keeper, like a dresser, refining, unlocking, and revealing his inner potential. The other is working for the next pay raise, for the next promotion, for the next good job. 10 years down the line, who do you think would have found the most favor and would have made the most progress in his career and finances? Thank you so much. Watch out for the next video in the series Fishing for Gold, Fishing for God. Cheers.